Here we want to graph f of x equals 1 over x minus 3. So let's identify the basic graph. We'll use 1 over x as a starting point. Okay, then we could see here we have a horizontal translation, 1 over x minus 3, like that. That's our final graph is going to be a shift to the right 3 units. Okay, remember when you subtract inside the argument of the function, you shift to the right. When you add, you shift to the left. Okay, so we're ready to graph this. Okay, so knowing what the basic graph of 1 over x looks like, when I plug in 1, certainly I'll get 1, and anything less than 1, my numbers, my y values get infinitely large. And when I plug in anything greater than 1, my y values become fractions that are infinitely small. So this thing is asymptotic to both the x and y axis, like this. Okay, when I plug in negative 1, certainly I get negative 1. And the same thing, when I plug in negative fractions, the reciprocal of that gets infinitely negative there. Okay, and the y values, when I plug in large negative numbers, that's going to tend towards 0. So down here, I got these asymptotes as well. Okay, so now the shift to the right 3 units takes this vertical asymptote and shifts it to the right 3 units, 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to write in the asymptote here with a dotted line. That would be the new y-axis after the shift. Okay, so when I shift this point over 1, 2, 3 points, I'll get this part of the graph, asymptotic to the x-axis and asymptotic to this new vertical line. And this point here would get shifted over 1, 2, 3 to there. Okay, again, still asymptotic to the x-axis and the new vertical asymptote. Okay, so this black graph is a rough sketch of f of x equals 1 over x minus 3. It's also important to notice that 3 is a restriction to the domain, right? The points get infinitely close to 3 but never attain it. 3 is actually a restriction.